All right, and the mechanoids, they are attacking. And it looks like they're going to be sweeping around from the north side unless they start digging. And they are digging. Of course, they're digging. Marble. What? What fucking marble is he going to be digging at? There's no marble exposed to them, fools! Unless there is, and I just don't realize it. Shotgun, shotgun. Hopefully they pass close enough for everybody to get some shots in. Soul, you don't have a weapon. Cry, you don't. Axel, you definitely do. I'm probably going to have to lock the door, too. The Scythers I'm mostly worried about. And this one, he's already on his way. Of course, he's going for the Blasteel Auto Door. I don't think he's going to make it, though. Not even close. Robot Trader. Excellent. Digging at granite. You're going all the way around, you son of a bitch. To the tree farm. I think what he's going to try to do is dig his way right around here. Which is smart, but... Chirp, chirp, chirp. Jerk. More like jerk, jerk, jerk. Stop that! Oh, he's retreating. I don't know where to. Everybody run the other direction. The centipedes are going to take forever to get down here, though. Super annoying. She's already back over there, of course. Juice, can you see him? Oh, no. Of course not. He's blocked. Where'd the Scyther go? Oh, there he is. Good job, guys. You guys just go off duty. He's already gonna give up. Please don't shoot each other. Oh, Axe just got shot. Good job. He's dead though. Now we just have the centipedes to worry about. Excellent. I guess. All right. Robot Trader probably dropped those robots. Well, as long as he gives us a deal, I don't really give a shit what he drops. Who shot you? It's hard telling. Fucking. This is the Uzi. Which belongs to... Somebody. Nova. So apparently Nova shot you. Hi, DJ. Rams. Yeah, Axe has got the fucking white rust hair going on. Starwalker. Oh, there's nothing wrong with extracurricular activities. I partake in my own, I'm sure. I've been known to get to be imbibed. Get imbibed? Idiot. I don't know if I should wait for these guys to get all the way around. You know what? We'll have Juice, not Dick Nick. It was going to be DeMarth to help him. Or Axel, but no! Juice, you just come out here. Forget about the preaching, goddammit. We don't have time for that. Yeah, all of our long-range guys have been hit by friendly fire. And plus, we have this trade ship to talk to. And I better do that before I just leave Juice out there for hours. Five mining mods. No thanks. I wish we had more silver. I would have taken the components and the steel as well. Whatever. I guess Juice can just hang out up there and shoot a McBangbang for hours. There's one going all the way around, but it's gonna take him a while. Oh, are you? Well, that's not an operation. You're just getting medicine. And if you're not getting operated on, you've got the robot feeding you stew. You probably already been bandaged up. Yeah. Oh, you got hit with the Uzi too. So did DeMarth. Fuck. We're probably going to have to take that Uzi away from Nova. See, Axel's fine, I guess. One of them's incapped. The other's heading around the other way. You go down there, Juice. And DeMarth. As long as he's bandaged up, he'll be fine. Steam World Heist. I don't... I certainly don't recognize that name. But I believe you. If I feel the need, get the time, I'll check it out. This is probably the only mechanoid I'm really worried about going out and getting once we finish killing it. The other ones are all the way around the other side. Fuck, that one's not even fully dead. Off duty, unlock the door. I don't care anymore. We'll go fetch him someday. Maybe once we start getting more desperate for components and steel. But for now, I need everybody to return back to the... all the jobs that I started him up with. Let's see. Wool cloth, vodka. That's probably the only way that Nova's managed to get any kills or anything. Oh no, he does have three kills. One human-like, two animals. What? Oh, two downed. For some reason, I read that as two drowned enemies. So yeah, he has had a few kills. One being a person, or a human-like, which is close enough. Oh, I forgot about the golden showers, too. Let's tear apart both of those. And... oh, apparently I can't. Can't choose the material! Damn it. Oh well, sad day. One of the Gentillas? You're probably right. It'd probably be fine, though. If one of them did get hit, so they'd get doctored by something. Oh, the wood... I'm an idiot. I don't know why I was looking at the steel one. Herder, just ignore that one. Whatevs. Don't want to interrupt Juice. Trying to recruit Alice. And failed. 2.4% chance. Oh, Dicknick's using that shower. Don't take shower. Deconstruct shower. And... there we go. Wow, 500 gold each? I guess we can afford it, but damn. Your enemies tearing each other apart. Yeah, that's, it always give you a nice feeling, Wumble. The last colony we had, we got attacked by a group of slavers, but we managed to capture one of them. They blew up a bunch of our shit with suicide vests. But the one we captured, we recruited onto our team, strapped him with the suicide vest, and sent him back to their base to sacrifice himself. So, well, what sort of... do we get beauty out of these, I imagine? Yeah, 125. But being so tiny, it's still considered a dull room. Like, we need a big shower room. Awful. Awful. Impoverished wealth. Rich. Yeah, we need, like, big shower rooms. Oh, that'll be something to aspire for. Probably enlarging a bathroom coming further down this way with it. So we can have like large handicap stalls. Because apparently that's what our colonists want and desire. Oh. Oh my. That's a fire. Take care of it, Juice. Well, we don't have Cthulhu yet. We've got all the spells for Shub, Niggurath, but none of them are particularly useful in my eyes, so I don't really care so much. However, we are working on another god now. I don't know which one it is. I can never remember that. Nyarlathotep. Apparently, they're Egyptian. Or they cosplay as an Egyptian, supposedly. No! Not all the berry bushes, no! What's our food anyways? We got lots of stew, damn it. 8 pizzas, 12 burgers, loads of stew. Oh yes, we've got a nice little, variety of various foods. Smoke leaf and psychoid leaves. The hell is that? Oh. Apparently I can't count. I was wondering where the fuck the fire was coming from. I didn't know the raid was still going on. I thought... okay, for some reason I expect... I remember something totally different. Unless this guy comes from somewhere else. I don't fucking know. Just hide, Nova. See, this is what Nova gets for shooting all of his fellow colonists. Luckily, these things are very slow and very stupid. Juice will back him up. Maybe I should have Nova, like, run all the way around? Yeah. Send Nova all the way up here. Juice finally got in range, but can't do much from there. And he's coming back anyhow. Come back, Nova. We need bait. Oh, he's coming back. You probably get some shots off. Run away. Oh, Katie's up here. Oh, Katie, you've got a gun. Juice, you need to get back in range. Come down here to the marsh. Nice. Good job, guys. That's great teamwork right there. Oh, what the? What are you doing? Oh, right. Huh. I didn't know he was going to be unforbidden from out that far. That's fine. That's perfectly fine. Oh, so it's my fault, huh, Nova? It's my fault you can't hit anybody except for your friends. It's called fire control. Just little taps. You don't gotta go full burst. Right, another research lesson is up. And I was going to put the statue up here, but... Nope. That went in the pool hall anyways. Leadership. I didn't even notice that bar. Oh. That's cool. I didn't even notice that feature. So leadership is affected by... Well, it affects their level. But it's affected by the average opinion. Which is good, especially for Juice, considering she's beautiful and everybody loves her. She's also psychotic. Really only has, like, one friend here, and of course that's Cry, and her love for Cry is dwindling slowly over time. Look at that. Cry is crying. Cry saying goodbye to Jimbo. Again. For the last time. But I'm sure he'll be back again to say goodbye another time. But it's not like he's going anywhere. Oh, wow. All this dirt. Wonderful. Poor trees. Really shouldn't even have these guys worrying about all this. Like, unless the actual wall itself is on fire, which you can... Well, I guess you can't put it out from the other side if it's the belayered wall. Whatever. Don't worry about any of this garbage. Where are you going, crafting bot? Oh, you're going after a mechanoid? Well, there shouldn't be any left then. Goodbye, bees. Oh, the fire won't spread that fast. It'll be fine. 19%. 10%. 20%. They're not going anywhere. Damn it. 16 burgers. So it looks like the stew's really helping out. Keeping everybody fed. And distributing food evenly between... different food groups. My favorite food groups: stew, pizza, and hamburgers. Oh, what you got there, Magubo? With the bees. Yeah. I used to have the same one up on the gift wall for a long time. But shit. Oh yeah, I do still have the soundboard clip as well, I think. I'm pretty sure it was ripped from, or it was just a copy of the same file that we used for Payday 2 when missions would start up, instead of the audio for Hawk's HUD, because it had like a little starter sound music clip. Just had him screaming about some fucking bees. Well, we do have a tree farm started, but of course I'm growing poplar and that takes a while. Besides, it should start raining anytime now. Or snowing. The game tends to do that when things begin to burn. Whatever happened to that caravan that we ordered for? Has it really not been that long? Feels like it. Poor Nick Cage. My favorite part of the movie is still him punching out the lady while he's cosplaying as a bear. There they are. The traitors have arrived. What? It's one fucking dude. We should have the industrial folk showing up as well. Yeah, I can't stay here for long.
Stay here for long.
You fucking serious? You fucking serious? Yeah. That one, I don't know if it's still up on the soundboard, but it's definitely been used for the soundboard more than once. My favorite was always the image on the Piety, Indiana map. Piety police station map for Killing Floor 2. Good shit. Alright, caravan from industrial citizens of Night Rock are approaching. There are quite a few of them. Though I suppose it doesn't really matter so much as what they have on their buffalo, but hopefully they can navigate the flames and not burn to death. And Kramer has developed a nicotine addiction. Well, good for him, we grow our own tobacco. Calm down, fires. Nobody has to get hurt. Oh, here comes one caravan. Oh, I think Chris has already caught himself on fire. He is already burnt on his neck, his torso, and his right leg. He's on fire again. Why are you just walking through the flames, you fool? I better get juice out here, just in case somebody gets incapped. This is ridiculous. Don't you dare, Chris. Don't make me turn on God mode and make it start raining. Wait, what? You guys can actually get through there? What the fuck are you doing? You're gonna have to go back out and go all the way around. Just keep going. You can't swim, you fools. Alright, I think we're good. Yeah, we never actually did get around to that, did we, Mouse? Maybe someday. Maybe once you make your valiant return. The Aventura is doing okay. Critical alert fire. Really? First trader made it in. Not exactly safe and sound, but he made it back. Cleaning rock rubble. Really? No. 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 Go back. Oh no. Oh no. Please don't walk straight into the pyre. They're walking straight into the fire. Please stop walking straight into the fire. Okay. Apparently it's no big deal. That's fine. Okay, so they have flame retardant raccoons with them. Alright. Alright, everything's fine. Never mind. First trader Chris, he's up, staggering his way around, covered in burns. Oh, there comes the snow. A little late. Better late than never. Sandra got burnt. Has a Med-X addiction. One of them's on fire? They'll be fine. It's a snowing. Don't know why he opted to go through the wooden door instead of the auto plus steel door, but okay. Let's go talk to Chris. Let's see. He's got a bunch of dry agave. Fucking hippie. Some simple meals, cougar meat, gazelle meat, polenta. He has five components, some cloth, some Brabant hide, cougar skin, medicine. He only has 1776. Fuck yeah, America. He only has 1776 silver on him anyways. Gun fiber, steel. I would like to buy the steel. And that titanium. But he doesn't have much of it anyways. 190 wood. We will take it all. 71 gold. We're actually good on gold. For now. Sell him the tentacle meat? Well, the tentacle meat I can use to make kibble. I don't even see any tentacle meat. I see the regular meats. Doesn't matter much anyways. I'm mostly worried about the textiles. So, like, all this shit needs to go. I have too many different kinds of material. It's taking up way too much room in the stockpile. Got quite a bit of fish scales, too. Deep-hide. The Mego leather. That shit's expensive. Of course, this is already too much for this guy. Shoggoth. How about some of that? And it's all I'm really worried about. It's not like he has too much else I'm going to go out of the way for. Yeah, that's fine. Well, Chris, you disappoint. Apparently these rebucks are hurting. Oh, they burn up a little bit too. Poor bastards. Enough zebra meat? $1,700? I'd say about $2,000 would be enough. We'll never be able to go back to that, though. Well, not until the next wave of rabid animals tries to kill us. Be all drugs. Okay. Ooh, what the hell is that? Large serpent humanoid thing. We want one of the octopoids too. Made out of blocks. A person-sized piece of material in the shape of a snake man sculpted into an artistic form. Shadow number zero. This piece bears a depiction of DeMarth deeply kissing Dicknick with a few clothes in sight. DeMarth is locking eyes with Dicknick. The expressionistic style of the central scene clashes with a pop art depiction of the background. There is a trout in the distance. This depiction tells the story of DeMarth and Dicknick becoming lovers on the 15th of summer 5501. It's only beauty of 8. That's garbage. Total garbage. Market value, garbage. I almost don't even want them to keep it. And hell, they already have a huge fancy statue. This one's weird because it kind of looks like it's supposed to go into a corner like this. I guess we'll go ahead and put it down there. That way everybody can see what DeMarth and Dicknick look like naked. But the trout though, yeah. It's not any specific trout, just a random trout. Just in case you thought you recognized that trout. Just make this clear, you don't know that trout. A mystery to you. Well, the rest of the other traders are arriving. Good night, Erden. Have a good rest, friend. Apparently they're all going to eat lunch up here too, which is fine with us. There's more than enough seating for them. See what Lansing has to say. They've got raccoons. It's pretty ridiculous. Oh, I like how expensive these alligators are. They're even more expensive than giant hollas, for whatever reason. These guys are interested in buying food from us too. And charge quite a bit for it. 93 simple meals. I need to really lower the threshold for simple meals. Or the number, at least. We've got 7 components. Only 1,500 silver, though, which is really disappointing. Buff out. They've got wine. We've got 4 crates of sake. Though, they're not offering a whole lot for it. We've got Simplest Steel. Psychic Shock Lance. Eye Prosthetic. Charisma implant. And they're just interested in buying a bunch of the clothes we've got. Well, we need to make the room. They've got flat screen television. Wouldn't mind having one of those, to be honest. Gotta get rid of all these clothes, though. I'm sure by now everybody's had more than enough time to pick out what they want to wear. And that almost evens us up already, so... No, don't sell them all those meals. We want a good chunk of his silver, though. How about 15 simple meals on hand? That sounds good to me. Well, that cleared up some room for us. Still have all these textiles, though. Yeah, I might have to be one tile further for the television to actually work out for the dining table. Unless I moved it, of course. Or put up another wall. Does tend to be where a lot of colonists hang out at. Or hell, just in the kitchen in general, because everybody comes through the kitchen. That won't work out either. Unless it's right there. That's too awkward. Okay, we'll just slap it down right there. I'm actually really impressed that I can put it there, considering there's a vent in the way and there's a light there. Just stack it on top of both of them. Well, this is all going to be a dining room for us. What I need to do is I need to work on getting a new workshop so I can move all this other garbage out of here. But I have other priorities before we move on to that. Put it in the game room? Yeah. That's probably a better idea. And maybe I can put up some pews for them to sit on? Watch television? A couch would probably be more comfortable, wouldn't it? But I don't know if I can... Oh yeah, I can spin them. Zebra hide couch, awesome. Should go like this, I would think. But it looks like it's backwards. How the fuck do I couch? Did I mess that up again? No. Better not have anyways. 50 watts. A high-tech glass television with crystal clear image and richer color. More entertaining than a grainy flat screen TV. 130% effectiveness. Entertainment strength factor. Excuse me. Beauty of 11. A table in front of the couch. You think so? Put a couple tables there and maybe like a little stockpile for booze or something. Booze and cigarettes. Booze, cigarettes, and weed. There we go. Let's see here. It's clear, copy, paste, paste. Let's see, cigarettes. Well, this one's with cigarettes. We'll fill this one with joints. Then we have whiskey, I think. Not enough whiskey, though, I don't think. It'll be fine. It'll be fine. You probably put some food up there. Like, pizza, cheeseburger, or stew. Whichever comes first. Then ice cream and yogurt for the last one. I know food. I know food will spoil there. I know. What I was thinking was doing is building it like a tiny freezer up here. That's what we had in Frostgash, I think. Maybe I shouldn't even bother. Maybe you should just stay a boost. Because see, the thing is that there's not even that much distance that they have to go to eat. Because the dining area is just right down there. If I end up making any place for food, an extra spot, like a pit stop, it would be out here. But I don't need to, because this place is a little bit more centralized than what that was. The mini freezer mod? No. Nope. I've had too many problems with I've had a lot of problems with mods that give you like extra storage and stuff for some weird reason. I don't know why, I just do. And maybe we should have parties up here too, instead of down there in the dining hall. Holy shit, a textile trader. Amazing. That one worked for you? I never tried it. I just know, I think it was the extended storage mod. That one in particular really fucked things up for me. More tables? Yeah, probably. Probably. Why did they break? Oh, and I thought I was bad with having only a little bit of leather here and there. Nope. Let's sell. What's our zebra leather up to? $365. So we still have more buffalo leather than anything. I guess we'll sell everything else then, including the Mego. Sea snakes, squidiggles, however in the fuck you're supposed to pronounce that, squidiggles. Jesus. So that. Oh boy. We are back in the silver, BB. We're back at it. So much silver. And we have, quite a bit more room left. Which is awesome. probably put like more tables down here, I suppose. That's not even going to be enough to cover us. Well, maybe it will be for now. We'll just use the linkable pews as seating for that set of tables. And we've got joints, booze, and cigarettes up here now. And apparently this is where the crafting bot wants to hang out as well. Nice, Starwalker. Have a good rest. See you next time. Maybe. Possibly. Oh, wow. We finished. We don't need dirt anymore. Well, I take that back, I guess. Oh, that sucks. Apparently we were going to get a bunch of steel down here, but instead we got a bunch of fucking lights. Did I mess up the couch? I probably did. Well, that looks like it may be okay. Yeah, we still have this marsh area down here. I guess we'll do that as well. Mark all that up. OMG. Actually got Alice. We're going to have to execute you. In her childhood, Pivot was responsible for keeping the tribe's fire going. She took this responsibility very seriously. And she's also retaining... Well... Retaining, what the hell's wrong with me? She doesn't even have an adulthood backstory because she's still 17 years old. She's not even an adult yet. So we kidnapped ourselves a teenager. Nerd rage. She's angry and in some cases intelligence can lead to extreme strength. And Pivot is a prime example. Research and melee up. Let's see. She's unusually sensitive to psychic phenomena, which is not great. And... She is abrasive, as well as straight. First thing we want to do is just go ahead and remove her restrictions. There's plenty of beds open. I'm sure she'll pick a bedroom out. My voice is dying. No! Pivot. How about... We set you up to help cook. So you already have a little bit of skill in there. Don't worry about the researching or much else for that matter, I suppose. If you're not cooking, you should probably be hauling or cleaning. Need as many chefs as possible. Speaking of which, I should probably have a chef teaching other chefs how to cook. I don't even really have anybody who specializes, specifically. Yeah, they all prioritize cooking anyhow. But another set of hands in the kitchen is really going to help. There's too much shit that needs cooked constantly. I'm thinking about putting another door on this side as well. Somebody will find a way to shoot you in the back. Sooner or later. Actually starting to work up a burger surplus. That's exciting. Let's see, 24 burgers, 2 pizzas, and 15 stew. Because I have burgers and pizza just set to make forever. Oh, yeah, she'll be perfectly fine. You know, there's nothing bad that ever happens here. No, never. Well, just kind of fuck things up. They started the door, but they didn't finish it. There we go. They kind of vented all the cold air out of the freezer. Today's class is about to begin. Smoothie. Where's he? There's the ice cream. A sweet frozen treat made from milk. Affects movement and blood pumping. All right, Wolf. Have a good sleep. Man, those trees are starting to piss me off now. They take way too long to grow. So there's a few trees that we can grow that grow faster. Ironwood, spears and tools, and we also unlocked some new stuff to grow in general. Quite a few things since we last looked. What about teak? No. Cecropia? Yes. We'll take Cecropia. I have a hole in the farm, leaking warm air. Yeah. Well, no. Actually, I don't. The, apparently the water forces, counts it as a separate room, because this is indoors and this is outdoors. And there is no effect to the heat here, I guess. So, RimWorld physics. So the way that the deep water works is essentially as like a fucking wall. Because nothing can pass it, period. Hi, Coconut. Thanks for hanging out. Have a good sleep. I'll see you next time. Oh, already 6.2% grown on that first tree. See, did that? Oh, Pivot didn't even get to make it to the first cult meeting, which is kind of sad. I think we're getting close to turning back on the crafting bots. Or rather, start our bills back up for more blocks. Because we need more marble, as per usual. What I could do to set them up for marble blocks. Let's suspend that one. Because I think... Yeah, it already started on a marble chunk. Well, that's weird. I didn't realize that the kitchen bot actually farmed too. That's cool. Another poison ship. This one right out front. Well, that's convenient as fuck. Oh, and apparently I forgot to run more power conduit. Of course. Yeah, I didn't even touch the front embrasure. Got a little bit of steel, so... I've been meaning to make... these for some time. Let's get our let's get a couple of turrets up. And then we'll start pew-pew-pewing. And also, with once this water is finished being placed down, we'll mine a... like a little tunnel to get into this embrasure. That way we can shoot at guys lined up along our front wall. Yeah, I'm sure you'll end up catching one of them. Someday. We wait till daytime. We'll wait till daytime too, so we can actually see what the hell's going on. So if they reach my crops from there, I'm gonna be super pissed. It's like they home in on farms or something. Imagine what that's what they probably do now. Straight up. Night, Axel. Trees take a little bit of time to plant as well. Alright. I guess that shit does spread pretty fast. Let's get everybody out here. Because this is going to be a bit of a slaughter. It's slaughter on time. Or something stupid like that. Who needs a gun range when you got poison ships that drop in places like this? Ah, yes. That'll look really cool at night with the blue LED rope light going down this tunnel. That'll look pretty nifty. I'll just pick somebody to plink that fucking ship with. About Fox, you've got that revolver, so why not? Really? You can't hit that from there? Oh, there you go. Juice, you can go off duty. Just keep those fucking animals away from the front gates. Is These turrets don't have the greatest reach. Oh, fucking sweet. Love my quantum stockpiles. Make sure we forbid that door. Let's get metal fabrication. Refresh rate on those military turrets is kind of fucking awful, to be honest. Oh, we'll unforbid those two. Oh wait, I forgot to take care of the ship itself. Goldeneye, you're still up here. You go out there and shoot it. That pistol's supposed to be pretty sweet anyways. Plink, 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 plink. Good job. Second poison ship destroyed. And still no way, I-Core. It's garbage. Gonna take Juice out there and beat down the rest of these mechanoids. Too many of them left alive. Meanwhile, trees are growing slowly. So, grab some more of our own, I suppose. This one here. Well, at least the Scyther wasn't so bad. And yeah, I guess that is it. Should get us some more components and steel. How everybody has a little bit of skill in plant cutting. Wait, and by a little, I mean none. Because you don't have skill in that. You idiot. I think plant skill, plant cutting skill, that should be affected entirely based upon your manipulation efficiency. I would think so, anyways. Good raid either way. Either way. If it's gonna mix... if it's gonna miss this one too, that's fine. Your cult-mindedness is still in the dead center, so... we'll get you someday. That is a lot of milk. Almost feel like I need another food prep table, just one for just making milk and another one for turning the milk into cheese. What? Game got paused. Ooh, I met, what the hell's going on? Is somebody getting attacked? Or I may have gotten an infestation. Yep, there it is. send Juice down here to beat these fuckers up. Take their lunch money from them, Juice. All right, leave the body down there. We don't need it. Oh, there's another one. I couldn't see him. Thank you. Wow, I did manage to fuck up my stockpile. Damn it. Oh god, here we go again. Juice? Dicknick's trying to burn down the fucking temple. You son of bitch. You son of bitch. Arrest him! Alright. Rescue. Of course, Dickneck dropped his fucking meal on the pew. So now his dinner is burning. Good job, Kimono. Yeah, another one for food prep. Another one for cheese. Just cheese. Sweet, sweet cheese. We'll put it right there. We'll have Juice build it first before she should goes off and gets medical attention. So yeah, we want this one just for making cheese. Do it forever, damn it. This one can help make cheese too if we run out of beans to turn into milk. Yep, imagine that. Four Fox failed on building a wall. Beautiful. Though, I am going to have to change the stockpile size because I fucked up my count. Unless I build a bunch of tiny quantum stockpiles, which I'm not going to do. Walls are hard to build, damn it. If you say so, sure. You say so, my friend.